Assalamu alaikum. I'm going to be showing you a prom dress that I need to do a few alterations to. The prom dress is, which company is my trying to find? It's a specialized company that does the prom dresses, and it's a quite an expensive dress. Beadwork, lovely grey color. It's a very wide ghair and it's a trend type, but it's way too long. So what we need to do is we need to do an alteration to it, where we're going to cut the bottom trim down. Now the difficulty with this is that because it's a trailed dress at the back, we have to make sure that we cut evenly all the way around. And measuring, what we're going to do is it's been box pleated, and the cut is a circle cut, but then it's box pleated on the circle cut. The circle cut is similar to the one that I have shown on a ghair. So measuring the length that we require is approximately the box pleating length is about 41 inches. So what I'm gonna do is I need a very wide open space. Every few generally now, when it's a made-up dress, there is a difficulty in trying to get this absolutely right. Initially what I did was I made the young girl whose dress it is wear it, and rather than cutting from the waist down, if it was a full circle all the way around, we would measure from the bottom up. But because this is trailed at the back, we'd have to measure from the waist down. Now the way I would suggest, if you have a dress like this and if you need to do alteration, then what you need to do is get the person to wear the dress and make them stand on a stool with the shoes that they're wearing, and then from the bottom of the stool go around and measure and sort of even it out all the way and mark it out, rather than taking the gamble of laying this on the table and trying to cut this out, because it is quite a difficult cut to do when you're, especially when you're on limited space. So what we're going to do is, like, I marked this out every few inches. Now initially it's going to be okay, because what we have here is we've got the mark of where at the bottom of this was this net attachment, and this net attachment, what that does is it stiffens it out, and the turning was done on this net. So we're going to be adding that back on, but before we can add that on, obviously we've got to cut, it's a massive ghair, we've got to cut into the silk, because the silk lining is going to be long as well, and we've got to cut on the back of the dress as well. It's way too long. Now at the back, obviously it's trailed, and you can see I've pinned it, and that's the kind of length, but I'm not going to go totally according to the pinning. I am going to measure it and go waist down. So what I'll do is I'll take the hanger out and try and lay this flat and then cut away. Now the excess that we have left over, what I've got to do is try and make a little bit of sleeves. Now the difficulty, I mean, like, our girls go to the proms as well, and they like to obviously get something fancy like this. It's a quite a costly dress, but unfortunately a lot of these styles are fairly revealing and don't have sleeves, and mostly around the chest area and so on as well, they're quite revealing. So obviously then the mums have to do the alterations and try and get these suitable to wear. So okay, so what we'll do is take the lining towards the inside. I'm gonna push that lining towards so that that's not, because we're gonna have to cut this one at a time. Push the lining back and then try and lay it as flat as possible. Start from the center, measuring from the center downwards. So this is the central. It's quite a difficult thing to actually start off on, because obviously it has a massive flaw. Okay, So what we're going to do is we're going to just take these two pins out and try and lay it out as flat as possible. Close the window to try and stop the air from blowing this away, and then we're going to mark this, start the cutting from here and sort of slowly go all the way around, making sure that we measure from the waist downwards and we keep the distance exactly the same. Okay, so I've started cutting into this, and as I'm going along I've just pinned it here, and I've just pinned it here because I want to keep this as much as together as possible so that we don't go. I'm going to take out these pins, and as we're going along we're going to keep the round, as much of the round ghair as possible. Now obviously we've taken away the backing because we've got to make sure that this is all symmetric. So it's going to be a gradual process of cutting this. So again, take the tape measure and from the waist down measure it 41 inches and take a marking, and then again measure 41. Keeping both the fabrics . Do you know, when it's somebody is such an expensive item, you're a little bit obviously more hesitant because you don't want to be ruining somebody's special day, especially like a prom day, and girls are quite emotional about that. Now at the moment the ghair is actually quite even, it's only past the halfway mark that it's gonna go into less. Now we have got a marking of what we have is we have approximately 4 inches coming off. So at the moment I'm just going to go by this 4 inches because it's too difficult to measure all the way down from the top. Pin these into place as you go and pull more of it towards yourself. Now slowly it's gradually becoming a little bit, the ghair is becoming longer towards the back as we start approaching the back. And the thing that I don't want it is I don't want it too far dropping also, but I don't want it to. Okay, so the lining is double lining. Again, you need to turn the dress towards the opposite side, just like we did with the lining, and then make sure that all these four pieces are evened out and just pin them together, because it's a very difficult cut to do to make it right. So what you want to do is make sure that your start is good. So before starting off, just take all the pieces and just pin them together before. So we're going to start, and this is obviously, this is not gathered, so it's a little bit easier than the other look, than the back, than the front, the top layer, sorry. So what we want to do is measure from the top, and we want it approximately 41 inches, 42 inches, and just mark it off there, and then you want to go 42 inches there as well, and then create the 42 circle cut. And you want to cut away all this excess. And you want to cut for the front, and we want approximately 41 inches for the front. The back was just marginally longer, so measure from the waist down, measuring it 41 inches in the center, and then go in a bit and go 41. From here, what we'll do is we'll do a gradual lessening. Now, before we add the bottom layer and do all the turnings, what I'll do is I'll try and get the girl in to get her to try and try this on to make sure that we've cut it sufficient, because if it needs any more trimming, then this is the stage where we need to do it at. So, I don't want the lining overhanging the dress as well. So the best way to do this now is to just get her to try it on, and then once everything is right, then do the turning, apply the net back on to the top layer and the bottom one, just do a gradual turning. Now I'm going to give you a little bit of an insight into what is the ghair of this. It's got a double lining, and the lining ghair here is with this dress, the lining ghair is about 72 inches, so 72 and 72, 154, I think. That's the lining, and then the top layer, it has obviously the gathers as well, and this is a very wide ghair. Let's have a look what we've got, how much fabric is used here. It's like one of those 10 meter dresses. If you remember a long while back, I did a 10 meter dress as well. So I'll give it you in yards. Okay, that'll give you, that's 2 yards. That's 4 yards. That's 6 yards. Okay, it's approximately a 10 yard ghair dress, a prom dress. So what I've got to do now is all this fabric that's come out, we've got to design sleeves out of this. Now it is a slightly biasy cut is what we've got here, and I don't want to add pieces, but I want to give her full sleeves, and there's a bit of a marking there as well. I don't really want to. What I'll do is, there's a slight bit of a marking there, I'll cut the sleeves and I'll wash this prior to attaching. You know, when it's a trail dress, even if you just try it out, you end up getting marks. So I'm going to cut the sleeve and I'm going to just give it a little bit of a wash. I may need to add just a little bit of a piece towards the back just to get she's only slim. I think we'll get it out. We'll have to do it at a slightly angled cut. That's the only way we're going to get this out. What I'll do is, I'll do a slightly longer sleeve but tighter fitting sleeve, and I won't add lining, so when they've got gathers it will actually stop the skin from being apparent. So she'll have more of a ruched effect on the sleeves that way. Okay, she can have a little bit of gathers in the sleeve, and that way, you know, the skin won't show as much. It's difficult for girls who do bada, who do cover their skin then. Okay, we have got material left and it has got, does require. Okay, I'll wash this prior to attaching it on because it has got a little bit of a mark. So I'll stitch the sleeve up, get her to try this on, then add the rest of the pieces, the net to it, and see how it works out.